Hello, and thank you for your time today. The focus of this talk will be on oligonucleotide intact mass conformation on the BioAccord system. Here is the presentation outline. First, I'll give a brief overview of the BioAccord LC-MS system. Then I will demonstrate the molecular conformation workflow using several different types of oligonucleotides. First, the mass-prepped OST standard, then larger molecular weight oligos obtained from IDT, and then three different types of modified oligos obtained from ADD Bio from the UK. Here's a picture of the complete BioAccord system. It's comprised of an Acuity UPLC I-Class Plus, which contains a binary solvent manager, sample manager, column compartment, and a detector. And for oligos, we'll be using the TUV detector. The mass spec, or the RDA, you can see here the small footprint of the mass spec. It's almost the size of the Acuity stack. And then this informatics is compliant ready. Informatics and instrument control is all done on Waters Connect. Here are some unique features of the BioAccord. First, all common tasks that are needed to set up the instrument is all automated. This allows for efficient and consistent setup of all parameters and calibration. You can see on the front of the instrument, there are three bottles. These reagents are calibration solution, wash solution, and locked mass solution. For ease of use, these are all supplied pre-prepared and pre-packaged. You simply have to mix and add them to the instrument. Next, intelligent diagnostics. There's a built-in health system in this instrument that monitors for problems and provides guidance in resolving them. You can see on the front panel here on the instrument, it's green color. This says it's ready. This is an indication the sample is either ready or it is running. Should there be an issue with the instrument, the front panel will display this amber color and say check. It will also display an icon of what the predicted problem is. In this case, there's detects a leak. Then the user would go into the software and click on the resolution button, and this will step you through with pictures step by step how to resolve that problem. So this gives clear cues to the user if something is wrong with the instrument, and it also lets you get back up and running without having to wait for an engineer. There are several supported applications. First, intact protein, for instance, intact monoclonal antibody or subunit analysis. Intact oligonucleotide analysis, which we're going to be discussing here. The other applications are peptide mapping, release glycan, and also to be released later this year is peptide multi-attribute monitoring. Okay, let's start with looking at oligonucleotide standards on this instrument. So let's have a look at the experimental conditions. First, we're using the OST mass prep standard. This is a purified and quality controlled standard for consistency. It contains five oligonucleotides ranging from a 15 mer to a 35 mer. The separation is done in an Acuity UPLC column, 2.1 by 50 millimeter. And the solvents are using ion pairing agent, triethylamine and hexafluoryl isopropanol. Specifically, solvent A is 7 millimolar TEA, 80 millimolar HFIP, in millicube water, and B is half the concentration of A in 50% methanol. For the MS detection on the RDA, we're running this in negative mode. The resolution of this instrument is 10,000. The MS acquisition is done in from 400 to 5,000 M over Z. The TUV is at 260 nanometer, and the flow rate is at 0.3 mils per minute. Here is the Waters Connect hub. This is the interface for launching specific applications and other informatics tools. The molecular weight conformation of oligos is done in the Unify application. So here is the intact oligo method in Unify. The first step is to specify all the expected components. So in this case, you can see the OST standards listed here. Then put in the expected retention time, expected mass in Daltons, the expected wavelength, and finally, the time window, which is for the integration of the TIC. Next, you would set up your processing parameters. There are two different types of deconvolution algorithms, BaseSpray and MaxEnt1. BaseSpray is typically used for lower molecular weight oligos, and MaxEnt1 is used for larger. You can see at the top you would input your parameters. You input M over Z range, then you output mass range, and then the charge states observed. And on the bottom you would select molecule type. For oligos there are two, oligonucleotide and phosphothiolated oligos. If your oligos are phosphothiolated and contain sulfur, then you would use this model. It's a better isotope model for deconvolution to get better mass accuracy for these modified oligos. So here are how the results are displayed in UNIFI. So you see at the top is the component summary. This is a list of all your identified oligos, the expected and observed mass, the mass accuracy, as well as you can get UV purity put on the table as well. And this is reading the percent area off of your UV trace. On the bottom, you have the chromatograms, the MS, which is TIC, or the TUV trace, which could label all your identified components. And then for a simplified view is the component plot or component summary. And this lists all the identified components by name as well as the molecular weight output. So let's look at some more details of the data quality. So here you're looking at the mass spectra from the top panel is the 15 mer down to the bottom panel, the 35 mer. So here you can see each of the oligos give a bimodal distribution of the charge states. And a wide range of charge states are observed, from a minus 2 all the way up to a minus 15 of the 35 mer oligo. So here is an example of the sensitivity on the BioAccord using different injections of the OST standard. On the bottom is a 10 picomole injection on column. The middle is 1 picomole, and the top is 100 femtomole on column. You can see there, even on the 100 femtomole injection, there is no problem seeing nice peaks for all five components in the mix. Here gives you an example of the resolved isotopic distribution of the 35 mer oligo. Here is the minus 12 charge state zoomed in, and you can clearly see the monoisotopic peak here. So the 10,000 resolution of the instrument is clearly enough to do this type of work. In the previous example, I was showing you the molecular weight conformation of just the main, most abundant species in the mixture, the five oligos. But you can also load more on column and to look at getting the identification of all the impurities as well. So here you can see that you can see the failed sequences all the way from a DT10 all the way up to DT35. So you could put these retention times and define these in the software as well. So then if you defined all the components in the software and then reprocessed, you'll get the output component list that would look like this. So all your components would be identified, you'd get the response area and the expected and observed retention time with mass accuracy. UNIFI has a very comprehensive set of reporting tools to allow you to create customized reports. We can supply you with standard templates, or you can create your own. Here's an example of a standard template. So here you see the BioAccord logo. You could change the cell for your own company logo. And then I'm displaying my TUV trace and my TIC trace with all the identified components. Then display the component summary with all the expected mass and mass accuracy. Then the component plot, which shows all the oligos with the molecular weight. And then you could have a UV purity table where you show the percent area of all the components in the mix. So let's have a look at a little larger oligo, a 60 mer from IDT. The molecular weight of this is 18,000 daltons. And so you can see the integrated TIC and TUV and the component plot with the molecular weight, with very good mass accuracy of 6 ppm. And the insert shows the quality of the MS spectra. And now you can see it a wide distribution of charge states and more Gaussian shape. Here's another example of a larger oligo, 100 mer, with an expected mass of 30,000 daltons. So here you see, again, more as you get larger in the oligos, the distribution of charge states is more Gaussian, but you can see a wide range of them from minus 19 to minus 38 with very good mass accuracy again. Now that we've looked at a wide range of unmodified oligos up to the molecular weight of 32,000 daltons, let's look at a series of heavily modified oligos. These oligos were synthesized at ATD Bio in the UK. They consist of common modifications used in therapeutic and diagnostic use. The data set we're going to look at now is oligos that are modified with a sugar, GalNAc, and 2' methyl oxyethyl modification, referred to as MOE modification. So there are three oligos in this mix. First in the table is an unmodified 20-mer with an average mass of around 6,000 Daltons. The second oligo is modified at the 5' end with sugar GalNAc. It's denoted with a red X and the structure is above the table. In addition to the GalNAc, there is a linker also. So with these two additions, you increase the molecular weight of the oligo by 610 Daltons. The third oligo in the table is heavily modified. You can see from the sequence, which is now color-coded, any nucleoside that it remains black is unmodified, but all the other ones have been modified. Below the table is the nucleoside structures and the modifications. For the adenosine and the guanosine, the modifications are with methyl oxyethyl at the 2' position. This is a very common position when adding modifications to oligos. Cytosine and uridine have two modifications. One, a methyl group is attached to the base, and also the 2' methyl oxyethyl modification. So with all these modifications to the mass of the oligo, the mass of the oligo increases by 1,200 Daltons. So here's a chromatogram for this oligo mixture. UV trace at the top and TIC chromatogram at the bottom. We're using the same column and same ion pairing agents. We just slightly modified the gradient to get better separation of this mixture. So you can see the unmodified comes out first, the GalNAc modified second, and then the heavily modified later. But you can see you get very nice peak shape for all three oligos. So here is the spectra for the oligo mix. The control unmodified at the top, the GalNAc modified in the center, and then heavily modified at the bottom. Again, you can see for this size oligo around 6,000 to 7,000 Daltons, you're getting the bimodal distribution of the charge states, but you're easily able to observe from the -2 to the -10 charges. Here is the base braid deconvoluted results after the three oligos were automatically processed in UNIFI. So here you can see the unmodified as well as the modified oligos still gives great mass accuracy. The next set we will look at is an oligo that is modified with a fluorescein tag as well as a 2' O methyl modification. There are two oligos in this data set. The first oligo is a 28-mer, which only contains an inverted thymidine at the 3' end of the oligo, giving a molecular weight of 8,600 Daltons. The next oligo listed is modified at all the positions that are shown colored in the sequence. Firstly, at the 5' end, there is an addition of a fluorescein amidite tag plus a linker. The nucleosides are either modified at the 2' O methyl group or fluorinated derivatives are added. These are shown in circled red. Therefore, the delta mass increase with all these modifications is 1,092 Daltons. Here are the chromatograms, the UV trace, as well as the mass spec chromatogram. And you can see you get good separation of the oligos, the unmodified coming out first, and then the modified. And once again, when you look at the ESI-MS spectra for these components, you get a nice wide range of charge states represented with the bimodal distribution, the control on the top, and the modified at the bottom. Here is the base braid deconvoluted result for this data set. And you can see, regardless of if the oligo is modified, they both give very good mass accuracy. And the final data set that we're going to look at is a set of four oligos. They are all methylated modified oligos. So here's a set of four oligos, two unmodified and two modified. The nucleosides are modified with the 2' O methyl. You can see that they're not very large oligos, all around 6,000 Daltons. The idea here is to take a mix of oligos, modified and unmodified, and see if we can separate them and get good mass accuracy. So here are the chromatogram traces, and we can separate both control, both of the controls are separated from each other, as well as the modified oligos that come out later, but they are well separated too. And very nice MS spectra for both components, the unmodified on the top and the modified at the bottom. And here is the MS spectra for the other two components, the unmodified at the top and the modified at the bottom. Here is the base braid deconvoluted result for all four oligos. And you can see excellent mass accuracy for all four components. So in summary, I hope I showed you that the benchtop BioAccord system is a high-performing LC-MS platform. The system, with automatic instrument setup and self-diagnosing, now allows greater accessibility to a wide range of users. Accurate mass data is consistently achieved for routine molecular confirmation of both unmodified and extensively modified oligonucleotides. And thank you for your time.